Hello everyone. Continuing with the video guide on using the MetaTrader 4 Exness platform. In this video, I will guide you on how to use available indicators and trading robots, as well as how to import external indicators and trading robots into the MetaTrader 4 platform of Exness. It can be said that indicators and trading robots are essential in determining market trends. They are a supporting factor that almost every trader needs to use. This is the Exness Market Channel, where we provide the most useful information about trading activities on the Exness platform. We are a leading development partner of Exness. If you're new to Exness Market, make sure to hit the subscribe button to stay updated with our latest videos. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, and our team will get back to you as soon as possible. You'll find the registration guide and the latest Exness updates in the video description and pinned comment. Besides this channel, you can also visit our Exness Market website to explore more about Exness. To use the indicators and trading robots of the MetaTrader 4 platform, we need to go into the Navigator tab. You can find the tab with the yellow star icon, or you can press Ctrl plus N. You can also go to the View section and select Navigator, and it will appear. Indicators are concentrated in the Indicators folder. Here, you can see that we have many different indicators. These are the default indicators of MetaTrader 4 that Exness provides us. You can go here to drag them out. If you want to use a specific indicator, left-click on it and drag and drop it onto the screen. The next step is to modify the indicator's information. Many indicators require us to adjust their settings to best suit our usage and strategy. For the Bollinger Bands that I am currently demonstrating, I will use its default parameters. The next step is to set up the visualization section. In this section, we will configure which timeframes the indicator is allowed to display on. Currently, I have it set to display on all timeframes. You can also check or uncheck all timeframes and then select the specific timeframes you want it to display on. Here, I want the indicator to be displayed on all timeframes, so I will select all timeframes. The levels section displays the indicator's parameters. However, for Bollinger Bands, we do not need to set this section. Some other indicators will require additional level settings. Depending on the indicator, below, we can set the display color of the indicator. For example, I will change it to green. Then I will adjust the line style of the indicator. Next, I click OK. As you can see, I have successfully dragged the Bollinger Bands onto the chart like this. Similarly, if you want to use any other indicator, you can drag and drop it onto the screen. Due to time constraints, I cannot introduce each specific indicator here. We will gradually learn more about them in the future. If you have any questions, you can leave comments below the video, and the team will assist and answer you. Regarding indicators, we have indicators that follow the price action like this, and there are also indicators that display in a separate window below. For example, we have the stochastic indicator here. I will drag it onto the screen. For now, I will use its default settings. And then I will click OK. As you can see, it has displayed a separate window below. When it displays like this, it reduces the space for the price chart. If I want to make this display smaller to increase the price chart space, I will move the mouse cursor to the horizontal line. A double-headed arrow will appear. Left-click on it and drag it down. As you can see, the price chart space has become larger. If you want to modify the information of any indicator, you can double-click on the corresponding indicator or right-click on the screen and select Indicator List. A table of indicators that we have dragged onto the screen will appear. If you want to edit an indicator, double-click on it and modify the information. After editing, click OK, and the new information will be displayed on the screen. After finishing the modifications, we will click Close. If you no longer want to use an indicator, right-click on it and select Delete Indicator. Alternatively, you can right-click on the screen, select Indicator List, choose the indicator you want to delete, and then select Delete to remove that indicator. Just like how I just deleted the Bollinger Bands, setting up indicators also involves some other advanced techniques that we can learn more about. For example, how I add a moving average line. Normally, the moving average line would follow the price, like this line, but we can also set the moving average line to follow another indicator. For example, I will make it follow the stochastic indicator. I will drag the moving average line and drop it into the window below. In the apply to section, I will no longer leave it as close. If I leave it as close, the moving average line will calculate the average based on the closing prices of the candlesticks. But here, I will click the arrow and select first indicators data. Then click OK. As you can see, the moving average line I just drew is now displayed in the window below. And it is calculated based on the price levels of the stochastic line that I had previously added. Based on the correlation between the MA line I just drew and the stochastic line, I will get trading signals. You can align them here to view them. Press the middle mouse button, and it will show a crosshair line like this, making it easier for you to see. Or you can click this button, the crosshair button, and it will show the crosshair line like this. The indicator setup we just did was for one product tab. However, we have not yet set up the other product tabs. If we want to transfer the indicator settings from this product tab to another product tab, we will do the following. Go to the product tab where we have set up the indicator. Then go to the template section and select Save Template. Next, I will name this template. For example, X Trading 2. You can give it any name you want. After naming it, I will click Save. Next, I will go to another product tab, select Template, and choose X Trading 2. Immediately, the indicators that I set up in this tab have been transferred to a new tab. This way, I can easily transfer indicator setups to different product tabs, making it easier for me to determine market trends for other products, reducing my setup effort. It's also very convenient that we can copy this template to another data drive. Later, when we reinstall the trading platform, we can copy this template back into MetaTrader 4 to reuse it without having to set it up again. Just choose Save Template, then right-click on the box above and paste the template you saved previously into this section. And you can use it. Any templates you don't use here can also be selected and deleted. For example, I click here, then click Delete, and it has deleted these templates. For using trading robots, we will proceed similarly. There will be a separate section to store trading robots, which is the Expert Advisor section. By default, MetaTrader 4 only has two trading robots like this. However, the specific function of a trading robot depends on what we have programmed inside it. Here, we don't know what these robots contain, so we can't use them yet. Here, I will only guide you on how to drag them out for use. As for how to use them specifically, we won't discuss that yet. If I want to use a specific trading robot, I will left-click on it and drag it onto the screen. Note that we want to apply that robot to which product, so we will drag it to the tab of that product, just like the product tab I am demonstrating here, which is the USD CHF product tab. When you first drag it out, you will modify the trading robot's information, and especially here, you also need to click the Allow DLL Imports and Allow Live Trading buttons. You can modify other information of the trading robot, then click OK. When you click OK, the trading robot will appear in the top right corner. Next to it, there is a face. And currently, it is a sad face. A sad face means that the robot is not yet active. If you want this robot to be active, you need to click Auto Trading. When I click Auto Trading, the red dot here has turned green. And the robot's sad face will turn into a happy face. If this is a robot to assist with trading, then this robot can already execute trading orders. If you want to stop the trading robot's operation, turn off the auto trading button. If you want to completely remove the trading robot, right-click on the screen, select Expert Advisors, then select Remove, and I have removed the robot. Now, suppose you have trading robots or indicators, but you haven't yet imported them into this MetaTrader 4 trading platform. Here's how to import them. Go to File, select Open Data Folder. I will maximize this. Next, select MQL4. If you want to add more indicators, you will paste the indicators you have into the indicators folder. It's this folder. You just paste the indicators here. And note that MetaTrader 4 indicators will have the extension X4 or .MQL4. This distinguishes them from indicators for MetaTrader 5. If you want to add more trading robots, go to the Expert section. It's also in the MQL4 folder, the folder we just opened when we selected File. Here, select Open Data Folder, and we will paste the trading robots here. After pasting the trading robots and indicators, we will close this folder. Then, we will restart the MetaTrader 4 platform, and we will be able to use the newly imported indicators and trading robots. The way to use these new indicators or trading robots is similar to the default indicators and trading robots on the platform that we were introduced to in the previous section. Thus, I have now finished introducing to you the operations to use indicators and trading robots, as well as how to manage indicators and trading robots on the MetaTrader 4 platform of Exness. I hope the information I provided is useful to you. Thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to give the video a like and click the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it to receive the latest videos when the channel releases them.